Hello students, in today's lecture we are going to study about phyla, okay, phyla globosa, that is the type study under the phylum mollusca. Okay, so first we will see the systematic position. Phyla globosa is classified under the kingdom Animalia, phylum Mollusca, class Gastropoda, class Gastropoda under class Gastropoda is further divided into subclass Canogastropoda and then order Archaeteniglossa and family Ampullariidae and genus Phyla species Globosa. Okay, this is the systematic position. Okay, for you need to remember. For the type study, you need to remember kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. Okay, no need to remember the subclass and all. Okay. So after the seeing the systematic position of phylum, now we will see the habit, the different characteristic, general characters of the phylum. Phyla globosa. The phyla is commonly called as an apple snail, okay, and it has a soft unsegmented body which will be covered with the mantle, and the mantle is further covered with the shell. Okay, this organism will show asymmetric animal. It is asymmetric animal because in this what happens, the body is spirally coiled, or the shape, the shell is spirally coiled, okay, and it appears to walk on a foot. Hence, it is classified under the class Gastropoda. Okay, they are found in the fresh water, like ponds, pools, tanks, lakes, and all. Okay, and paddy fields, okay, and they can also live on a land. So it is an amphibious animal, that is they can found in a aquatic medium also plus in a terrestrial. So they are adapted for the terrestrial respiration plus aquatic respiration too. Okay, then it is herbivorous in habitat. Okay, then they will feed on a leaves or vegetation. Normally they exhibit they are found in a area where aquatic vegetations will be available, like pistia for food and all. Okay, hence they are called as amphibious, which is being adapted for life in water and on land. Okay, and this animal creeps very slowly by its ventral muscular foot, which will be covering about 5 cm per minute. Okay, around it takes 5 cm, they take 1 minute. Okay, the movement of animal is like the gliding movement of planarians, that is during rainy season this phyla comes out of the ponds and make a long terrestrial tours. Okay, and thus they are respiring directly through air. Okay, and can overcome a long period of drought condition, and thus they buried in the mud. Okay, and this time during this period they are inactive, and this is called as a estivation period or in summer sleep. Okay, then we will see the external features. Now we will see the external features of phyla, that is a shell of phyla. Shell of phyla or we can directly compare the shell of Gastropoda. Here is a univalves, that is it is without valve and it is coiled around the central axis in a right handed spiral. As you see in the image, The top of the shell is will be having an apex which is formed first, okay, and growth of the shell will take place from it. Okay, so apex contain the smallest and the oldest valves, WHORL. Okay, and below the apex there is a spire which will be consisting of a several successive larger valves or coils, and they will be followed by following there will be the largest valves or the body valves will enclose most of the body. Okay, then they will be having a lines between the valves which will called as a sutures. Okay, and internally all the valves of the shell are freely communicated with one another. Okay, and such a shell is called as a unilocular, that is UNILOCULAR. Okay, the body of valve has a large mouth or opening. You can see na, a large mouth or opening, and there will be the margin of the mouth which is called as a peristome, from which the head and the foot of the living animal can protrudes out. Okay, and from the ventral side of the peristomium, the mouth lies to the right of the columella. Okay, and the shell is spiraled clockwise. Okay, then it is spoken, it is said to be a right-handed or dextral. Okay, and the outer margin of the mouth is called as an outer lip. Okay, and this outer lip will be having the inner margin, okay, which is termed as an inner or columellar lip. And in the center of the shell there will be a ventral axis will run or columella around which the walls of the shell are coiled. Okay, and this columella is hollow, and its opening to the exterior is known as a umbilicus. Okay, and this shell with the umbilicus or the umbilicate or it is perforated. Okay, and the lines of a growth of a shell are visible. Okay, while some of them will appear as a ridges, the shell of the Pila globosa will varies in colors from yellowish to brown to even black in color. Next is after the shell it comes the outer body organization. Okay, the body organization or body of Pila consists of head. The body of Pila is soft and it is divisible or consists of head, a foot and a visceral surface, or also termed as a visceral mass. Okay, in the animals they will be having an expanded head and a foot which will be come out of the shell, that is from the mouth, but the visceral mass will lie inside the shell, okay, that is within the walls. Okay, a columella muscles will arise from the foot and it is inserted in the columella. Okay, and it attached to the body of the shell, and this columella muscle will help the animal to withdraw in and out, to withdraw the head and this foot in and outside of the shell, and it also closes the operculum. Okay, then we'll now see the this about head. The head of the Pila is distinct, okay, and it is produced into the snout. The head will be bear two pairs of tentacles. The first pair of tentacles or labial pulps are small and lie in front, okay, whereas behind there is the second pair of tentacles which are long. Okay, in this you can see first pair of tentacle, okay, first tentacles and second pair of tentacle. The first pair of tentacles or labial pulp are small and they are lie in front, okay, whereas the second pair of tentacles will lie behind it and it is very long. Okay, these tentacles are hollow and capable of much extension and contraction. Okay, and the tentacle, that is the second tentacle which is placed behind the head, has a pair of eyes, and behind the tentacles, behind the tentacles on the head, there will be a pair of eyes which will be stalked, inside, and this stalked is called as a omatophores. Okay. Then next part, one more point is there, that is, at the side of the head, the mantle is produced into process called as a nuchal lobes, okay, or they are also called as a pseudopodia, okay, and these two pseudo, there will be two pseudopodia that are placed at the left one is much larger, whereas the right smaller. You can see in this, the left one is much larger, whereas the right one is smaller. Okay, this is the pseudopodia which is formed by the folds on the side of the head, that is the mantle lobes. Okay, and these are called as the nuchal lobes or the pseudopodia. Okay, then next is the visceral mass. The visceral mass forms the main part of the body and it is spirally coiled like the shell, okay, and it is covered by a fold of a skin known as a mantle or pallium, okay, and this in between the free margin of the mantle and the body there is a wide space called as a mantle cavity, okay, and within this mantle cavity number of vital organs are lodged or placed, okay. Followed by visceral mass, there is a foot. The foot is the ventral and the highly muscular, at the ventral surface it is flat and it is known as a creeping sole, okay. This foot is formed of two regions, that is, anteriorly it is called as a parapodium and posteriorly it is called as a metapodium, okay. This is about the body organization of pila. The next point is mental cavity, okay. The mental cavity and the pallial complex. The cavity which will be lying between the body and the mental is called as a mental cavity, okay. And it consists of number of organs which will be collectively called as a mental complex or the pallial complex. Okay, the first part that is formed by this is epitinae. Okay, this epitinae is a thick muscular ridge which runs from the anterior edge to the right nuchal lobe, that is at the posterior end of the mantle cavity. Okay, this ridge is divides the mantle cavity into right branchial or the tineidial chamber and the left pulmonary chamber, and this will play an essential role in aerial as well as in aquatic respiration. Okay, this epitinae. Okay, then now we will see the first one, that is the has epitinae divides the mantle cavity into two, that is the right branchial chamber or the tineidial chamber. Now we will see about the tineidium. Tineidium is, it is the gill which is used for the aquatic respiration, and this will be arranged at the right side of the mantle cavity. Okay, it will be having a central axis and a series of gill lamellae will be arranged on one side of this axis. And this arrangement of the gills lamellae at the one side of the axis will termed as, or this type of tinnidium is termed as monopectinate tinnidium. Okay, tinnidium. Then after the tinnidium, there are other organs which are found is the rectum. Rectum, it is the posterior region of the digestive tract, and it will be located towards the left side of the tinnidium. It runs parallel to the tinnidium, and it will be open into the mental cavity by the anus, which is situated on the projection called as a okay. The next organ which are found in a pallial complex is the genital duct. This genital duct runs parallel to the rectum on the left side of it. That is, this genital duct will be run parallel to the rectum on the left side. Okay? And the genital duct is either the oviduct in the female or the vas deferens in the male. Okay? And the external, they will be opening externally in the genital duct in the anus, okay, located near the anus, okay. And in the male, there is a copulatory organ will be present that will close the genital opening, okay. And this copulatory organ or the penis, okay, will be present, which close the genital opening. And at the base of the penis, there is a glandular organ called as a hypobranchial gland. Hypobranchial gland, the spelling is HYPOBRANCHIAL, hypobranchial gland. Okay. The next organ which are found in pallial complex is the anterior chamber of the kidney. This anterior chamber of the kidney will project into the branchial chamber near the posterior end by epitineum. Okay, epitinea, and it opens into the mental cavity by the renal aperture. Followed by anterior chamber of the kidney, there is pulmonary sac. This sac will hang from the mental cavity, from the roof of the mantle, and it opens into the mental cavity by the pulmonary aperture. Okay. Followed by pulmonary sac, there is an osprey is present. This osprey will be act as an olfactory in function. It is a comb-shaped organ which is attached to the mantle near the left nuchal lobe, okay? And it is formed of the central axis, and it will consist of two rows of lamellae. Followed by pseudopodia. Pseudopodia are the folding of the margins of the mantle on the either side of the head, and these are also referred to as the nuchal lobes. Okay, they are used for respiration. This is about some points of characters or external characters plus systematic position of pila globosa. Okay? If you have any question regarding this topic, then please let me know. Thank you, student.